Shut up.
Shut up.
Homie.
Nah.
Hey.
Another one. Another
make
one.
A wait.
One ain't enough, I need two. And that makes the ace with the deuce. Hit a triple double in the garden. Held on my left wrist like I'm Harden. Ran to the dealer, bought twin Mercedes. The European trucks for the twin babies. Don't let me have a son, I'm a fool. Send him to school and all my jewels. I want a boy and girl to fight for truth. Whatever God give me, I'm cool. I've been winning so long, it's like alchemy. I've been playing cards with the house money. 21 Grammys, I'm a savage nigga. 21 Grammys, I'm a savage nigga. I should even work back with niggas. 12 solo albums, all platinum, nigga. I know you ain't, I ain't talking numbers right. I know you ain't, I ain't talking summers right. I know you ain't walking around talking down. Saying bullshit when you a runner, right? Plain paddock, then had it. Flooded when I got it from Cali. That was just a thank you for us last year. Next year, gonna have to buy a pallet,
shining. Shining, 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 yeah.
Shining, yeah.
All of this winning, I've been losing my mind.
Yes, shining. That's it. Don't try to slow me down. It won't stop. Can't stop. Peace and greetings, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Planet Remix. I am your host, of course, Miss Blue, the Oracle. Tell me music is not magic if it cannot really just help to center you and get you into that space. I do want to let you know that the Blue Room is up and running and open. And if you guys want to come on over and jump on YouTube, you are free to do that as well. We will keep shining here and continuing live here on Planet Remix. So tonight we're going to be talking about spirit guides. This, I have to say, in all of the readings I've done, brothers and sisters and people from all over the world, all walks of life, all paths in life, has to be hands down, if I had to say at the top, one of the most asked questions is about spirit guides. Spirit guides. And why is this question so intriguing to us? We want to know about spirit guides. And I know that I started talking about spirit guides some years ago. And when I first did it, you know, it was a lot of questions, a lot of confusion. Spirit guides, are they ancestors? Are spirit guides angels? You know, are spirit guides gods and goddesses? You know, it was all of these questions about who were the spirit guides. So tonight, not only are we going to talk about the spirit guides, but we're going to talk to the spirit guides. And I want to invite all of you to call in, because right now I have with me sitting in my room so many spirit guides who showed up since earlier today when myself and Brother Bilal, we were kind of crafting out the energy for the show tonight, and spirit guide was what came on the forefront. They've been showing up. And some of them have some pretty, pretty emotional and overwhelming stories. And I found myself just being so captivated about just understanding who they were, you know, why they chose to be a spirit guide, why at this particular time they are here, and really the purpose of a spirit guide. So I know we have millions of listeners that listen, whether you're listening live or whether you're listening to a replay of this, whether you're watching it through any of the streams in your car, maybe you're driving and you're listening through us through YouTube Red, or you're listening to us on the download on iTunes or on your Android device, or you just happen to sort of stumble across this on social media somewhere, or however you find this. Know that your spirit guide is the one leading you to this space. So first, I want to talk about why this question intrigues us so much. And it's a couple of things that I want you to do while we're doing this. Is just kind of hold that thought, because we're going to be doing a spirit quest in just a moment to get ourselves ready just to receive all of this beautiful energy that the spirit guides are bringing in at this particular time. But I want to talk about why this question is one of the most asked questions. Because as human spiritual beings on the planet, we understand that there's many different parts of who we are. And if you're listening to this, you understand that like there's a part of you that you love to, you know, listen to music maybe. There's a part of you that loves spending time with your family. And then there's a part of you sometimes you go deep within yourself and you get caught up in your own thoughts. And you begin to start asking yourself that question. And this is the question that many of us have asked ourselves over time. And this question has absolutely everything to do with, why am I here? And truly, truly, from the first time you got your very first history lesson, how is this all connected to me? And when you begin to start looking in outer space and you see the stars and you see the sun and you see the moon and you begin to explore with the planets, whether you know anything about astronomy, astrology, or any of that, you can feel that there is a bigger connection than just you. And then the ultimate question, what happens after we leave here? So the truth is, two of the most fascinating things for us as humans on this planet is life and death. We are fascinated with death and what happens after we leave here, and does the spirit, does the soul truly live on? There's been so much proof that not only does your spirit live on, but that there are spirits here with us. And I'm not talking about the kind of spirits that Hollywood puts out that scares you. I'm not talking about the spirits that come back and, you know, want to do things to you. I'm not talking about those spirits, but I'm talking about spirits that generally have a love for this plight of being human and growing up on planet Earth, and really soul to soul making a connection with another spirit being, knowing that you are not alone. I don't care how lonely you feel in the physical, because that's a real state of being, but you are truly not alone. All of us, every single one of you, have spirit guides. And these spirit guides are with you all the time. We have some spirit guides that stay with us, and some of them work at many different levels. Some of your spirit guides are soul spirit guides. And then you have other spirit guides that come in and come out depending on what you're working on, depending on what kind of challenges you have, depending on what kind of task you've taken on, depending on what kind of research you're doing, and ultimately just depending on your mood and where you are. You can think of it like this. If you've ever found yourself in a position, maybe you were sad, maybe something happened or something just kind of got you down, or if you've ever walked by a coffee shop or you ever walked by a store and you see someone that could just use a smile. The spirit guides do just that for us. They're here to really give us that assistance. Along the way, they don't live our lives for us, but they are here to really help guide us, lead us, if it's something we need to learn, whether that be a life lesson, a matter of the heart, or whether that's something physically we're attempting to achieve, or maybe we're having a difficult time because a loved one has passed on and we really want to sort of get more of an understanding, the spirit guide will be there. And we've seen this play out in lots of movies and cartoons and, you know, animes and all of these things. Well, they're really real. So we're going to be talking more about spirit guides, your spirit guides, who's with you, why they're with you, how you can connect more with them. This is really a time where spirit guides really come in very heavily because we're coming to the end of a cycle, of a cycle as the planet know it. We're coming to the end of this year of what we're calling 2017. And usually towards the end of the year is the time that most of us need more assistance. So the spirit guides are here to help assist you with that. And no matter where you are in the world, no matter what situation you're dealing with, no matter what has happened, what you feel is going to happen, or what is happening, they are here to support you. No judgment, no funky attitudes. No moodiness, none of that shit that we do. Spirit guides aren't about that. They are truly your unconditional ride or die chick. And they are here and have taken a vow to really, really assist you in your life. Just like Planet Remix is here. To assist you, I'm here to assist you on this journey as we continue to grow up here on planet Earth, which, by the way, is a place we've all chosen to be. So, who are spirit guides? Spirit guides are individuals who have lived on Earth. They have worked here. They have learned things here. They have failed here. They have achieved great success here. They know what it feels like to be a mother. They know what it feels like to be a father. They know what it feels like to be a child. They know what it feels like to go to college. They know what it feels like to be broke. They know what it feels like to be rich. They know what it feels like to have addictions such as drug addiction, gambling addiction, sex addiction, social media addiction, any kind of addiction you can think of, they know. They know what it feels like to be innovative, to create something. They know what it feels like to hold dreams inside of your heart. They know what it feels like to have your heart broken, to be betrayed, to lose at love, and to lose at life. They understand all of that. They know what it feels like to be homeless. And these are the things they're telling me. They know what it feels like to be in an abusive relationship. They know what it feels like to yearn for love. And they know what it feels like to be completely lost and abandoned. They know what it feels like to win. They know what it feels like to shine. They know what it feels like to be lonely in a world full of people. They understand all of this. They know what it feels like to start something new. And I'll share something to you. One of my spirit guides who actually came to me some time ago. And you know, she shows up, but she doesn't show up often. And she showed up this afternoon, and I should have known. And, you know, just even sort of some of the things that I was dealing with here, you know, she just sort of helped to get me back focused and to get back on track and just to keep pushing through, just to keep doing it, just to keep focused, just to keep moving through that. Now, it's important that we have real people in our lives, good sounding boards that we can do that with. But it's also important to know that if all else fails and no one else is there, you have your spirit guides. And I'm going to talk about her a little later in the show, but she came back up to remind me. And to know, you know, it's something when you're speaking to someone who's been through sort of what you've been through, to really kind of give you a ray of hope. And so that's what we're going to be diving into tonight. I want to talk about some of the places that lots of spirit guides hang out at. And one of the places that spirit guides hang out at, one of the major hubs across the globe, is the spirit guides love hanging out in Grand Central Station in New York. And I can tell you, whenever I'm in there, it's just amazing to me to see all the spirit guides, because this is a place where they actually get to embody physical beings. And you get to see the manifestation of the spirit guides there. They love hanging out at international airports. That's another hub of theirs. They also love hanging out at movie theaters, believe it or not, spirit guides do. They love going to malls and gallerias and, you know, places and outlets. They love, absolutely love going to things like that. They actually love going to plays and shows, especially when they have a theme. Like in Houston right now, they have an amazing show that's going on. I think it's called Shen Yen or something like that. It's the Asian show, which is a magnificent show. It'll be traveling and definitely, you know, an amazing show. And soon Beyonce is going to be coming out in 2018. She's going to be a part of the Lion The Lion King cast. She's going to be playing a cast member on the play, The Lion King. How powerful is that? How powerful is that? So these are places, you can think of places wherever light is. Spirit guides love hanging out. They love hanging out at Planet Remix, because this is the work that we do, and we've invited them in here into this space. So they love hanging out here as well. So spirit guides is what we're going to talk about tonight. They usually come in numbers. And those numbers, we know that numbers have frequency, they carry vibration, they carry energy. And so all of these numbers, it's a reason why it's a certain number that's coming to you with these spirit guides and why they're showing up for you now. So I know if you feel in your heart that there is a message for you and your spirit guide, and I see so many of you guys on the phone lines now joining on, press 1 once you get on the phone line, 515-605-9794. If you want to come on so we can, you know, get your spirit guide to come on. Yeah. Get your spirit guide. So, we'll keep talking throughout the share tonight and talk about the spirit guides, but I do want to remind you to make sure if you're over on YouTube or YouTube Red listening to this that you do subscribe to the channel, and then that way you can see all of the broadcasts. I'm really sort of kind of pulling both of these platforms together because it is a major sort of intersection going on here with some major things that are happening on both platforms. And I'm very grateful for Blog Talk and very grateful for YouTube to be able to do this. So subscribe wherever you are, wherever you're listening to this at, and leave a comment. And don't forget to hit us up on social media. We'd love to hear from you there as well. You can simply just go over to Facebook and look for the Remix Radio and click like there. And once you click like there, you'll be able to see the show that's posted tonight. Leave a comment. I'll be checking in with those comments over there as well, Twitter and all over also. So we're going to get ready to go to the phone lines. And we're going to get ready to get in and talk about these spirit guides because I love talking about these spirit guides. I want to remind you guys again, the workshop is coming up. We are definitely super excited, myself and Brother Bilal. Luminosity is the workshop. We're going to be giving out some powerful, powerful rituals and things in this workshop, covering lots of information that's going on, all about illuminating the spirit, the body, the soul. Very powerful. So definitely want to invite you to come if you're interested. Question, Q-U-E-S-T-I-O-N, for blue, the number 4, blue, at gmail.com. Send me an email and I'll get the details out to you. It is not too late to attend. And no worries, it is an online event, so you can attend anywhere in the world. It doesn't matter where you are. As long as you have access to a computer and a phone, you will be able to attend the workshop, and we will possibly definitely have the recording available for you also. And also, if you guys want a personal one-on-one reading from me, which I do, you can check out everything in the show notes and you can contact me as well. I would love to do a one-on-one personal reading with you. There is a waiting list for that, but trust me, it is well worth it. So here we go. Mm-hmm. We're going to go to the phone lines. And what am I looking for here? Yeah, here we go. We're going to go to the phone lines, and I'm actually going to let my spirit guide, Sarah Ann, is going to pick who's going to come on, and I'll tell you guys about her in just a moment, but I'm going to let that sister pick. She's going to be the one to pick who's going to be coming on the line, and so we're going to go to the caller calling in from area code 214. You're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hi, Miss Blue. This is Bade, and I'm calling from Dallas, Texas.
Okay, greetings to you, Bade, from Dallas, Texas. How are you?
I'm fine, Miss Blue. How are you?
I am wonderful. Thank you for asking. Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Mm-hmm. So, Bade, tell me why you called in. You're just holding the line in anticipation, and let me know what's going on with you, why you decided to press one.
Well, I've been having a good day today, and I've been listening to music all night long, sitting on my balcony, and I was like, you know what? let me look at my email and see if Miss Blue is on, but I didn't get the email, so I started scrolling through the old emails, and I was like, let me just click on it. I think Miss Blue is on tonight. I think I can talk to her or just listen to her, so that's why I got on.
Mm-hmm. And so tell me what about spirit guides that led you to pressing one?
Ooh, Miss Blue, let me tell you about my spirit guides. Since you told me like 2 years ago that at the time I had 9 spirit guides, I try like some nights I may lay in the bed and I'm like, you know what, spirit guides, come to me in my dream tonight. And it's been like 3 times they've came to me in my dream when I went to sleep.
Oh, beautiful.
But for some reason, Miss Blue, I hate to say it, my spirit guides are ratchet. I mean,
no,
like,
not ratchet. No.
Yes,
what
Blue.
Happened?
Yes, I don't know what's going on.
Mm.
I'm like, there's one time when we robbed a store or something and stole the, my spirit guide stole a, what can I call it, a air conditioned unit from in a window. It was just so crazy, Miss Blue. I'm like, what's going on with my spirit guide? And then one time we was shooting and killing people. I'm like, okay, I don't know what's going on with them.
Mm.
I don't understand. But it's always funny to me when they come to my dreams. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just always so funny when I wake up. So
well,
you have to tell me about them. I know you
yeah.
One that was in Vegas.
Well, I'll tell you, I want to take a look now and see, because that was 2 years
okay.
ago. And right now, the total number of spirit guides that you have around you, Bade, is 9. You have 9 spirit guides
wow.
that are with you right now. And okay. interesting enough,
right.
so I'm kind of laughing at sort of kind of the humor our spirit guides will have when things are playing
yeah.
out for us. And so a lot of times when we don't have enough excitement or we're not doing enough things to really calm us down or take us out of who we believe ourselves to be, our spirit guides will put us in a situation so we can learn how to loosen up. So you stealing the air
okay.
conditioner, being in that, being somewhere else is really telling you that you're taking yourself way too serious.
Okay.
Way too serious. And one of your spirit guides, interesting enough, lived in Montana. And she
okay.
lived in Montana, and at the ripe age, she got married pretty late in life. She got married at 35 years old, and she was a stay-at-home mom. She was a housewife. And cooking and cleaning, like she did the whole nine, like wore the apron, you know, cleaned up, you know, packed the children's lunch, you know, ironed her husband's clothes. Like she was the perfect, absolutely perfect housewife. And she's the main one that's stepping forward with you. So she's kind of smiling with her hand on her hips. And so tell me how that relates to you at this time in your life.
Well, I guess I would say because there is someone that I'm still like madly in love with. And
mm-hmm.
I have hope and faith that, you know, me and this person that, I mean, like he's the one, like he's my husband or whatever. And that's been on my mind a lot. You know, we just recently, you know, started talking again, you know, as friends, but you know,
mm-hmm.
I just, you know, feel like he's my husband and I'm not letting that back down at all.
Mm.
And maybe that's why she's stepping up. I don't know.
Yeah, that could definitely be the reason. And so let me ask you this then, because a
uh-huh.
big part of what she's here to do is that she became the wife that her husband wanted her to be, but not the person she
okay.
truly was. And so I want you to take a look, because it's a reason this relationship is coming back up for you. Why do you think you two did not hit it off, or it didn't go further the first time?
Well, it didn't go further the first time. he said it was because of his PTSD. And I know I remember talking to you about this
yes.
a few months ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he said it was because of his PTSD, and he didn't feel that I could handle it.
Mm-hmm. And for those of you who don't know what PTSD is, explain that to us, Badu.
It's post-traumatic stress syndrome. Mm-hmm. People get it from trauma. My guy, he was actually in the military for over 21 years, so that's how he developed it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so what steps have you been taking so that you can prepare yourself for having to deal with this situation? I mean, let's face it, he's just very open and honest about what he has. But the truth is, when we get into relationships, holla if you can hear me, somebody always got a hidden fucking issue they don't want to tell you about and that we have to deal with. I mean, that's just life. You understand. I understand what the world is calling it for him. But the fact is, we come with issues as people. We have things we have to work through. So what do you think will be different this time?
Tell you the truth, Miss Blue, I'm not exactly sure. Maybe he'll understand that I am a very patient person.
Right.
That's one thing that I am. I'm a very patient person.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a lot for me to get upset. I do believe in people having their space.
Yes.
Well, I guess I'm learning that more now that I'm single and, you know, I'm here by myself. You know, I'm learning that more now, you know, to just enjoy your space that you're in.
Yes.
And why people like to have their space.
Mm-hmm. So, but that still doesn't tell me how you can be supportive to your possible husband in the future.
Well, also, you know, what I was thinking was that, you know, he goes to therapy like once a week, you know, so I was thinking maybe that's something that we can try to do together.
Mm-hmm.
I have joined like a PTS group online. I haven't been on there in a while, but I have joined a PTS group online, and they were very helpful. You know, it was like a group for people who support people with PTSD, and then it was
yes.
also some people on there that had PTSD. So whenever I ask questions, they were very helpful, you know,
right.
with the questions.
And so
I was like, I'm trying to actually learn about this.
Right. And I think that's a really good step, you know, especially since you kind of know this going back into this. And one of the things that I will say about this particular spirit guide, she was totally committed and dedicated to her family. And then after her children got grown, she learned to be totally and committed to herself and her husband. And, you know, the people she loved, but herself first, totally committed to herself
okay.
and living that out okay. and really maintaining her identity in the midst of being in a setting where you're supporting and giving so much to other people. And she really kind of mastered it, because I see her looking like hair done, nails done. You know, she got the high heels on, like she's doing it all. Absolutely doing it all from sun up to mm-hmm. sundown and still finding time for herself. So this makes sense why mm-hmm. this is one of the 9 spirit guides that's coming forth. The other thing is what I want you to do is to do, and this is a beautiful time to do a ritual. Anytime you have a relationship and you mm-hmm. want to rekindle it, what I want you to do is I want you to sit down and I want you to write out all the things that was challenging when you two were in the heat okay. of the relationship before. And then what I want you to do in a safe space, in your kitchen sink or bathroom sink, is I want you to sign it and release it and burn it. Because even though you two are coming okay. back, you don't want the relationship to be the same way it was the first time. You want it to be better.
That's correct.
You want it to evolve.
Okay.
And so this is going to help recycle some of those challenges that was there in the first go round of the relationship, releasing it into the ethers so that it can come back to you. So the nine spirit guides are here. One, to help you create prosperity, because I see that really creating some more financial things for yourself and putting certain things in place. And there's things you want to do, trips you want to take. Like, I see all kinds of things around you that you want to get yourself involved in and you want to do. So the nine is definitely here for that element of finance. And it's also here for closing out old things, so you don't bring old baggage into this new chapter in your new relationship, even though it's with the same person. And sometimes we tend to forget that it can be the same person, but we really have to begin to start looking through new eyes if we want to foster something different than the first time. Yeah. So there you go. Yeah. Your nine spirit guides.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Miss Blue. Can I ask you one other thing?
You sure
I've
can.
I've always wanted you to do this. I have your deck of cards, but I've never asked you to pull a card for me. Can you pull a card for me tonight?
I sure can. I sure can. Just tell me, just say stop when you want me to stop. Just
okay.
Say
stop. Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay, so the card that I pulled for you is card number 23, which is patience. And this is all about stillness, and it's about living in the moment of now. Not too far in the future. Not too far in the past. And if you look at card number 23, you will see a being that is sort of suspended in air. This is also letting you know that you are to pull upon all of your resources, spirit guides, ancestors, your higher self, the divine, the most high, your wisdom. It's about you utilizing and harmonizing all of the tools that you have inside of your being so that you can definitely have the patience. Have the patience.
Okay. Great.
And living in that moment of stillness. And sometimes when we don't know what to do, do nothing. Nothing.
Okay.
And it will come. It will come.
That's correct.
Yeah, it'll come.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Miss Blue. Thank
oh, you're
you.
So welcome. Please come back and let us know. And I want to send love out to you. You are definitely a highly intuitive sister. I really hope that in some of the future classes we have, that you would utilize those, because not only would it be benefit for you, but benefit for your spouse who's dealing with those things of PTSD, where you can begin to getting into some more modalities of utilizing all of your energetic energy, you know, to be able to promote yourself and promote this relationship, and also help to heal him as well. So I thank you for being a magic maker and listening in and using your intuition tonight that said, even though I didn't get the notification, I know Miss Blue is on and I'm going to come on and listen. So thank you. So peace and love and harmony.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Hold the
thank
line.
You.
Hold
you
the
too,
line.
Miss Blue.
Aww. I love her name, Badu, like Erica Badu. We're going to go to the next caller calling in from area code 3172. 3172, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hi, Miss Blue, it's me, Desiree from Virginia. How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you, Desiree?
I'm fine. I'm awake. Last couple of calls, I kept falling asleep, but I told myself, you know what? Tonight, you're not going to miss it, because I know there's something that you need to hear, so we're going to do this tonight.
beautiful, beautiful. So let's take a look, Desiree. Let's see how many spirit guides you have with you, the total number of spirit guides that you have with you at this time is going to be Real interesting. You have a total of 8 spirit guides with you.
Okay.
You have a total of 8 spirit guides with you. I'm saying interesting because that number 88 came up earlier today. I was speaking with an amazing sister out of the UK, and she was telling me about the number 88. And so I see that again. Very feminine numbers, the number of infinity. It really is the number about creating love and prosperity and really getting centered and being in a place of harmony. You know, when you think about 8 and just how it's just a smooth, if you've ever seen ice skaters when they're skating and they're doing the figure 8, yeah. It is just a beautiful motion. It is like all in unison going together. But I want to talk about your spirit guides, or one of your spirit guides that is coming forth. One of your spirit guides that is coming forth is actually a diplomat. He's a diplomat that used to live in New York City, but he actually was from Ghana. And he came to...
From where?
From Ghana. From Ghana. Africa, Ghana.
Okay.
He was from Ghana. Or Guyana. I always say it wrong. Guyana. He was from Guyana. He came from Africa, and he actually studied and went to school in the UK, and he was a diplomat for in the US, and then he went back to his country. One of the things that he studied, it had a lot to do with diplomacy. You know, that was sort of a big thing for him as a diplomat, you know, really to kind of smooth things out, keep the relationships going good, and, you know, kind of being that person, that in-between person. He acquired a lot of wealth during his life. He traveled a lot. He was able to take his family around the world and see a lot of things. He did miss home. Home was something he missed. And so eventually he did go back home and take his family after he was a diplomat for a while. But the reason he's with you, Desiree, right now is because he's really teaching you these things of diplomacy, of really how to present your ideas, to present your proposals, to present those projects you're attempting to bring forward, and learning how to do it in a diplomatic way. Really learning how to do it so you can really get people to see things from many different perspectives that perhaps they've never looked at things before.
Oh, wow. That is so relevant. And it's so funny. I was having a family issue today between my mother and my sister, and things got really heated, and I ended up was trying to go get my mom, so I ended up getting an Uber with this guy, and he was actually from Haiti, and that while we were driving, he said he was from New York, and he was like, oh, you would love to go to New York. And I was like, I always felt like New York seemed like a really busy city. I don't know if it was like really meshed with me. I feel like I would get a little overwhelmed. But I was like, but you know, I wouldn't mind visiting New York. And we were talking about traveling, and I was like, yeah, I really want to go traveling. I want to go to, you know, to Europe or go to Africa and everything. So it's so funny that you're bringing up New York and
Africa.
Diplomacy, because that's what I've been going through today.
Yeah. So he's really here to help you negotiate yourself, because he said that conversation between your mom and your sister, he really wants to show you that you didn't have to get yourself frustrated or even get them frustrated, and really how you could sort of bring sort of that harmony between all of you there and helping each other see each other's point of view. And that's what he's really here to help you with, is sort of to have that diplomacy, you know, to really look at those soft spots, because, you know, your mother has soft spots, your sister has soft spots, and you have soft spots. And so when, you know, your spirit guide is really going to help you identify what those soft spots are, so you can know when you're hitting that and you can do it in a very gentle way so that you can keep the conversation. It's nothing wrong with having a heated conversation, but when individuals walk away with a negative perspective, then that damages the relationship. And so, you know, he's really here to help you with that diplomacy so you can bring that harmony back into the family unit and the relationships.
Yeah, it's just been so difficult with them two because they have so much history and so much hurt between those two. So every little thing can just get, you know, heated and, you know, overblown. So I always try to make sure I stay as calm and as centered as I can and try not to attach my own emotions so I won't get wrapped up into it, but then also so they won't fight. But then I feel like both of them might feel like either I'm choosing the other side or I'm ganging up on one another. And I'm like, I just want you guys to be okay.
Yes.
And not fight. And then today I kind of got wrapped up in my own emotions because I didn't know what could go down because the blood can just get boiled so much. And I just was asking, like, I just needed help to try to keep calm and keep them calm. It's just, sometimes it can just be a little overwhelming, and then I want to give up. I'm like, you know what? Forget it. I'm just walking out because I can't take it.
Well, it's so good that you called in because your help is here. Your hope is here. You have a spirit guide, and that's what he's going to teach you. He sat at some very strong and intense negotiating tables, negotiating all kinds of things. Negotiating people to keep them out of prison in the U.S., from negotiating with his government to keep people from the U.S. out of their prison, negotiating contracts between different power companies, and negotiating with people who spoke different languages and had different ideas and values, which is what you're dealing with. And he was excellent at it. Matter of fact, he flew all over the world, and that's what he was known for. He was the diplomat. He was the one to come in and sort of save the day and really get people to step outside of themselves and be able to see things from a particular angle. So he's here to really kind of pass those skill set, those tools, and share them with you. So I want you to reach out to him. He is excited about helping you. In fact, he was helping you today. And that's one of the reasons he wanted to let you know you are doing very, very well. And he has some more skill sets that he can pass on to really help you with that. Mm-hmm. As well as travel, he says.
That makes me feel so much better that I know that I got someone right here on my side to help me out and get through that.
Yes.
I have two more things to ask you.
Yeah.
One, I definitely would love to get a card pulled on me, and then also just to see if my dad wants to say anything.
Okay.
If he's there at all.
Yeah. We can do that. Well, don't you guys love spirit guides? Because what are the odds? You can't make this stuff up, you guys. You just had this situation where you were the diplomat between your mom and sister, and the person who came forward is a diplomat. This is why I love this work. I love it. I love it. I love it so much.
I know.
I love it. So I'm going to pull a card. Just say when. And I have the Know Your Magic Oracle Psychic deck. So just say when. And I'll stop for you. And I'll pull a card.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Is that a win? When you say okay?
When.
Oh, okay.
No, win now.
Okay, I'm sorry. So here we go. The card I pulled for you is card number 21. I love this card. It's such amazing and beautiful energy, especially for your energy here. And I'm going to give you some things to take away. Card number 21 is share a breath. This is about divine exchanges. It's about relaxing. you know, really kind of dropping down in your body, finding sort of that place, that space that's in between your heart center and coming out of your mind, tapping into your Dantian, that empty space there, getting fresh thoughts. This is all about fresh thoughts, new perspective, fresh thoughts. In fact, you will see this card, two colors I want you to work with. One is going to be the color yellow, and the other one is the color of blue. So these are two colors you can bring around you. The yellow, this color is really going to bring the sunshine into your life. It's also going to brighten things up and allow you to focus and shine the light on areas. So whether you're dealing with a situation between your mom and your sister or even your own emotions, it's going to shine the light so you can find your way through the conversation. Find where you need to focus. You know, where is going to be the bright spot, you know, that's there. So think of that yellow light of that. The blue light, the light of truth and the light of spirituality. So you're going to have this blue light there because it's going to allow you to stand in your truth while you also support others. And blue light often brings in this whole energy of the server, being able to use our gifts, our skill sets, you know, things that we desire inside of our heart to share with the world. So use these two colors this week. They're going to help to energize you. They're going to help to keep you focused and really keep you moving so you don't get lost in the midst of everyone else's problems, and you can keep moving forward on a lot of the things that you're working on there. So this is all about share a breath and divine exchanges, and know that every single exchange you're having, no matter how difficult, how challenging, how wonderful, they are all divine, and they are lessons for you to take away, to carry with you in the work that you will be doing as well.
Thank you.
Yes. So that's card number 21, and that's a beautiful energetic number there, because 2 + 1 = 3. That's the number of self-expression, that 3 energy there, the divine trinity, the mother, the father, the child. You know, that is just that whole trinity. And so let's take a look and see what your dad has to say. Well, your dad came through, and he just got a phrase for you, girl. He said, stand your ground. He said, stand your ground between them two. Just stand your ground. And also, you know, one of the things he's saying, he's holding his heart, you know, for the family, because he knows that of some of these issues going on, he's at the center of a lot of this. And so that is something that he's also, you know, he's kind of sad about that, but he's sending his love there to your mother and also to your sister, and really saying, please forgive me, because he knows he's at the center of a lot of this. Yeah, he does. He does, my dear. He does. Yeah. Yeah. And he's hugging you right now. He's hugging you and sending you love. But that's what he's saying. And I hope that your mother and your sister perhaps can hear this, because that's what he's saying. Please forgive me. Forgive me. And he wants you guys to love each other and to support each other. You know? Yeah. Yeah. And everyone's sending you love too. And yeah.
Thank you so much. You know, one thing through this whole journey that I've noticed, I thought about it today, even hearing, you know, what you said with the spirit guide, just hearing that from my dad, you know, I've learned that you really cannot doubt your ability and know that you're so much more than this prison that you kept yourself in. And I remember a while ago when I called, I said I kept having this dream of being in prison and then escaping and wanting to be free. And I thought that just solely meant about, you know, what I want to do in my career or where I was in life. But it's so much more deeper than that. We really truly limit ourselves. And sometimes I start to reach out to everyone else to hear this message. But the whole time, every time I go to something else, it's already what I've been feeling already what I've been thinking.
Yes.
And for some reason, as people, we just doubt ourselves so much, and that it's that doubt, it's that non-belief, just in solely in yourself, that self-love that we're lacking so much. And if we will only just hone into it, no matter how crazy it may sound, no matter how, you know, unsure you may be, but if you just really take that step, and all I've been doing is trying to take steps every single day to say, you know what, I'm going to try it.
Yes.
And every time I try, I get closer and closer, and I go higher and higher.
Beautiful.
So I just want to thank you so much
Aww.
For just giving me another confirmation.
Wow. That was beautiful.
I
thank
really
you so
it.
Much for bringing on that confirmation. Mm-hmm. I mean, I really can hear your growth. And I know you are going to do and doing some amazing things here. And know that I'm here to support you. You know, you are a magic maker. So just stay the course. Just stay the course. Stay the course. You are doing it.
Yeah.
You are doing it. You are doing it.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Harmony and love to you, Desiree. Hold the line. How beautiful.
You too.
Beautiful. Beautiful, you guys. Wow. All right, so we're going to go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 5806. 5806, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from. 5806, we can't hear you. So if you're saying something, take us off mute because we can't hear you.
Hello, Brother Magi Tree.
Greetings.
Hello?
Yes, greetings. Who's on the line?
This is Brother Magi Tree.
Okay, greetings to you, Brother Magi Tree. I want to say it right. So hopefully I said it right.
Yes, ma'am. Magi Tree.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Beautiful, beautiful. Greetings. Where are you calling from?
Edmond, Oklahoma.
Okay, greetings. You're calling from Oklahoma. Wow, wow. Okay.
Yes.
All right. So what had you push one tonight?
I just felt it, and I was having complications getting a number and going through one number and then finding this one, and I was just like, it's meant for me to get through. I was telling my lady that I know I'm going to get through. I was confident in it. My heart was beating and everything because I already knew I was going to get picked.
Well, you already knew it. I know that's right. I love that. Well, I will tell you this. You have a total of 11 spirit guides with you.
Wow.
11. Now,
thanks.
Interesting.
Do you have any information for me? Oh, sorry.
Yeah. I'm going to give it to you. Is this your first time calling in?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay.
I've called in several times before.
Okay. Well, you know, hey, I'm going to tell you this because this is real interesting. One of your spirit guides, this is like so crazy. One of your spirit guides that's coming forward is a brother. And he's kind of taking me all over the place, but we're going to get to the point here in just a moment. So you must be embarking on some pretty big adventures here because this brother was born back in the 1950s and he actually is from Detroit. He's from Detroit, Michigan. But he ended up going to school in New York. New York is coming on the radar a lot here. But he actually got a scholarship. He entered a contest, won a scholarship, and he says he got a scholarship to go away to college. And he was so excited.
Oh, wow.
He said he was so excited because he remembers he wasn't going to enter the contest because he thought, there's no way I'm going to win. You know, it's the 1950s, black brother from Detroit, Michigan. But he did. And lo and behold, he won the scholarship full paid scholarship, like everything taken care of, to go to New York to study. So he goes to New York. And when he gets to New York, of course, Detroit, New York, you know, they're both cities. So he's kind of accustomed to that. But if you've never been in New York, there's no place like New York, just like there's no place like Detroit. But he's in New York and he's going to a fashion college. And he had this dream ever since he's been about 2 or 3 years old to start his own clothing line of fashion. Something at this particular time, he says, that has not been done by a man of color yet to the degree he wants to do it in America. So he goes to New York. He goes to this fashion college and he's given it all he got. He lands this internship to work for one of the larger fashion houses. He goes there, he starts to work with them. And finally, he gets his own store on 6th Avenue in New York. He's managing it. He's designing the clothes for it. In fact, he's telling me that people like Stevie Wonder, Lena Horne, Cicely Tyson, like a lot of our great Black actors and actresses came to him because eventually he started designing his own clothes. He was really the trendsetter that really was the jump off. And stores like Lord & Taylor, Saks Fifth Avenue, Bloomingdale's, he had his clothing in those stores long before this was ever heard of by any melanated man. And his name,
wow,
is Arthur McGee.
McGee.
You can Google it, you can study it, you can find out, but that's his name, Arthur McGee. So Arthur says that he's coming forth for a couple of reasons for you, because there are some things that you're embarking on. It is some steps that you're taking. And even though the path that you're taking is not the end result, it's going to help you be where you want to be. But somehow in you, you're not believing that it's possible. And he's here to show you that anything that you dare to dream is possible and it can come true, even if no one has never done it the way you want to do it before.
Okay. That's very interesting.
Share with us why it's
on my dad's side.
Mm-hmm.
On my dad's side, we have some McGee's.
Oh wow!
And right. And so when you said that, it really did. Kind of with the scholarship thing, when I was younger, I didn't think that I was going to go to college, and I got a wrestling scholarship.
Yes.
And I'm just wrote down some things and I'm going to just run it.
That's all right. Take your time. Yeah. So what is it that you're working on at this time?
Well, as of now, I feel like I've like taken steps back. Like I've made mistakes in my life to where I've slipped back and now I'm trying to get back on track.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And on top. So, and I do always have ideas as far as business. And I was a mixed martial artist for years. So I kind of want to teach people self-defense and kids, you know, with bullying and stuff.
Yes.
Teach women and just people, period, yes, how to defend themselves. And
yes. Well, you need to do it. He's here to really help you do it in a way that we have not seen before. He can show you. He's had a lot of setbacks himself. But in the end, it was all worth it.
Wow.
So he's here to give you, you know,
okay.
What is more powerful than anything is hope. Because without hope, there can be no dreams. And so Arthur is here because he said he feels like you're losing hope. And he wants you to get your hope back. That you can do this. That you can do this. And all of those failures will turn out to be gems, positive gems for you, for things to come. Their lessons learned. It's like gold in the bank. It's like money in your pocket. You can count on it.
Okay.
You can use it. It's going to be readily available for you. And he's here to help you. In fact, he says that just recently you seen a building that you thought would be perfect for you to set up that studio at. And he's going to help you get it.
Okay. Sounds real good. Well, it just sounds right up my alley. Like, I'm just kind of speechless. And with the whole, when I felt like I fell back or slipped, I was addicted to alcohol and I no longer drink. So
congratulations. I feel like
that's a big plus because it was destroying my life.
Yes. Oh.
And my body.
Well, Arthur said he was known to take a little sip here and there too, you know, so he feel you on that. Yeah. I don't know where that came from, okay. But he threw that out there. He said, yeah, he was a little, you know, maybe that's another thing you guys have in common.
That put a smile on my face.
Yeah.
And, it might sound corny, but I believe in magic.
Of course, it's not corny here because this is all about knowing your magic here on Planet Remix. You know that. Yeah. Well,
I do. And I beat myself up sometimes because I feel like I can be doing more, you know.
Like, listen, well,
as
you're,
far as,
you doing it,
my work.
You're doing it now. So you have 11 spirit guides. Arthur stepped up for first. Work with him. Have him show you to put a plan in action. Some steps that you can begin to start taking towards your dream right now. Before the end of the year, it is never too late. Never too late to start moving forward on those goals, on those dreams. And I'm so glad you called in tonight. Congratulations to you.
I am too.
Yeah, and I'm excited for you.
Much love.
Yeah, much love. Know that I'm here to support you. Please let me know how it goes. And much love. Hold the line. Oh, I am loving this. Wow. Arthur McGee. We got to check him out and see who that brother is. All right, let's go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 5712, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
I'm James from Woodbridge, Virginia.
Okay, greetings to you, James. Yes.
Love. I have a number of questions, so much to the point where it's hard to put them in priority. You know, trust issues and in-laws and such.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just willing to listen, but definitely in need of some guidance. And yes, just very much willing to listen to whatever you may have to say.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's take a look, James. So you got trust issues, 5, 6, 7. You have 7 spirit guides with you. 7 spirit guides. 7.
Okay.
7 spirit guides. And we're going to talk about them here in just a moment. Yeah, we're going to talk about them. I'm just picking up some stuff really quick. So, this is what I want you to do for me, James. Is you said coming into this, you said I have trust issues and issues with your in-laws. So I want you to think about all the things you have going on, because it is a lot. And out of all the things you have going on, tell me the number one thing that if you can get some clarity on this, this would help you so much.
Well, I'm worried about rumors getting back to my children, and just how to explain, they're not ready for them now. Well, I don't know what they're ready for. They're geniuses, but my wife just recently passed away.
Can I tell you something?
My father-in-law.
I want to tell you this. The card that came up for you was card number 8. Which is Heteru. And I seen her standing in front of me. So I knew at the core of this was your wife. And my condolences to you. I know it must be very, very difficult, you know, having someone so close to you pass away. And you said your wife just recently passed away. Yeah, I'll say to her. What was her name?
Lady Nicole Green.
Say it again.
Aleki and Nicole Green.
Okay. Aleki, Nicole Green. Ashe to her. And she's with you, by the way.
Ashe.
Yeah, she's with you.
I know. Yeah.
She's with you. And you said, so your main concern is to get your children back.
No, I have my children with me, and we're, helping each other. I think they're doing better off than what I am. My main concern is, people have questions, and, meet new friends. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, and how did that happen? And it really wasn't the best way that she passed. And even that is a question.
Yeah. I see she's telling me that it's so much controversy. She said, Miss Blue, literally she could become a conspiracy theory about what happened to her.
Yeah, so.
Oh. I said,
concerned about my children.
Yes.
And,
yes.
Because of, gossip gets around. And
so
I would just hate for them to
hear something that will bring up some questioning. So I want to see if we can bring your wife through. And by the way, she tells me, what did you used to call her? Because it wasn't the name you gave me.
Nicole,
that's what
but,
you
do. I mean, I call her late, Alethea.
Yeah.
And then I would play around and call her late lady.
Yes, that's the one she said, lady. So, one of the things that she's saying to you is she wants you to know how much she loved you. And she says that's real important for you to know. That she did love you.
I know she loved me. She hurt me bad, though.
Yeah.
And
she also let me know that she had some struggles.
Yeah.
And a lot of these.
I didn't realize this.
Yes. She had a lot of things that she was struggling, that she was battling with. And a lot of times when we hear these voices, when we hear these things inside of our mind. And a lot of her issues dealt with her childhood.
Mm-hmm.
And there were things that she just could not get over. And when we're in a desperate situation and we're trying to allow ourselves to function normally, sometimes we have to do things to make the pain or make it stop, make this go away. A lot of the callers who called in tonight and have called into Planet Remix have talked about feeling like they were locked inside of a prison. And she felt that a large part of her was imprisoned. She's saying to you how very sorry she is. But you were truly the best thing that has ever happened to her. And her children, she knows, have one of the best fathers. And she says, despite what she said to you, you were not the cause of her passing, because somehow you're holding yourself, James, responsible or partially responsible for her passing. Is that true?
Yeah. It's a part of me, yeah, a small part. I think some of the subconscious is not really in my conscious. I tell myself, it's like, well, you know, I did
everything.
I did what I could.
You did what you could.
Yeah. And I'm just looking to, you know, I bring in the in-laws, mainly my father-in-law. He says that I did it. He thinks I did it. And it's like, man, I mean, I understand you thinking that, but to just outright just come at me. And then not only that, just the way he did, it's like he didn't even come at me as a man. Like, you sent me a text message.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, listen. It's because a lot of people are hurt. And even though they gave birth to her, they didn't know her like you knew her. They didn't see her when she was at her lowest and down points. They didn't get to see that as often as you did. So now, tell me about her passing, because I see her laying down.
Yeah, we were separated at the time.
Right.
I got word that wherever she was at, the children saw her non-responsive. So they was the first one to see her passing. And they said to the guy that they were rooming with, the guy comes in after work, and they said, "Mommy's not waking up."
Yeah.
And so the guy looked at her and saw her in the praying position. Her back was to him.
Mm-hmm.
And so he left her alone. And when I heard this story, I'm like, why didn't your brother wake him, shake her? You know, the children are not going to just say mommy's praying. If they're bothering mommy and she's praying, then she would say, leave me alone. I'm okay. I'm praying.
Right.
You know, it's like, that's what, it's like, did he have a hand in it? And I really want, you know,
Listen.
I wanted to find out bad, and I said,
yeah.
It's like, you know, James, don't find out. Well, I mean, I wanted to find out, but the opportunities weren't available. And so I said, okay, well, it wasn't meant for me to find out.
So,
because, you know, that's the life she chose. And
right. So once you found out about her passing, because I'm seeing that it was ruled suicide and then natural causes.
Some people say suicide. I don't know. She wouldn't do that with the children in hand, but I don't know. They ruled it as an overdose.
Yes, and that's what it was. Listen to me. Listen to me. You more than anyone seen her when she was at her lowest point. And sometimes souls come here and they really yearn to go back to where they came from. But she is so sorry.
What were you saying? She wasn't coming. Yeah. I did a meditation.
Yes.
After her passing, and I was Anubis for her. That's what I'm going to show you.
Beautiful.
I got to come back here.
Yes.
Because we were on different paths.
You know,
she was still a Christian.
Yes.
And so I said, I'm going to be Anubis. You're not coming back here.
Yeah. Well, she thanks you. And she loves you. And you were and still is the greatest thing that ever happened to her. And she knows that the children are in the right place to be with you. And even though you two were not together, she loved you with all of her heart. And she's with you. And when you feel someone messing with your feet at night, she said that's her tickling you, even though you say you're not ticklish.
She's hanging around as a little baby.
Yeah.
My aunt, like, she's a baby.
Yeah.
My aunt's doing my daughter's hair.
Beautiful.
But she watches two children, but the baby brought this a bug to my daughter.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought the bug to my daughter and put it in her face, and my daughter got startled. I said, what type of bug was it? She said it was one of them bugs with a lot of legs.
The caterpillar.
Well, it was like a centipede, a millipede.
Yes.
My wife's grandfather gave nicknames for all the children.
Yes.
And he nicknamed her Centipede. And that baby gave her, the baby either gave her a centipede or a millipede, one of the two, but I didn't see it.
The
baby gave her a centipede.
Yes.
The same day, my daughter went to the Scout event and made a Girl Scout event to do a craft, and she made a bug cage. I said, wow.
Beautiful. They are around the children, and, you know, Nicole is asking that she hope you find it in your heart to forgive her father, to give him time. When people don't understand, that's just what they do. Do you understand? That's what they do. They lash out. They make accusations. They accuse people. But he truly will know that you loved Nicole and you loved the children. And you will be able to, you know, mend this relationship with you guys together.
Right. Because I want to, you know, my flesh really wants to get back to him. And I said, man, I could say some real hurting things to him.
Yeah, don't do it.
It would really last the rest of his life, whatever I would say. But, you know, I understand that that's flesh. And I really want to, make things work so that for family reunions and such, but it just, you know, when he makes that accusation like that, and I understand the thought of it, but to make that accusation and to declare it to me that you killed my, I'm like, dude, are you serious? I did that to get my children? Like, come on, man.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, now I, you know, it's like, nah, not sending my children to no family reunions. It's like anything that I'm doing is going to be supervised visits now. You are not going to be, my children are not going to be left alone with you at all.
Yeah.
You know, but it's, but, mm-hmm. you know, one of my concerns is, you know, being around people who they say, well, how did you pass? Or,
so here's what you say. Here's what you say when they ask you, how did she pass? You say, no passing is easy, but I know that she's with God. That's your answer. That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Because the truth of the matter is, you wasn't with her when she passed.
Because I was in Alabama at the time. You know, there, I told people it was a medical condition. But to real intimate friends, they were like, nah, man.
Here's the thing. So, you don't have to be ashamed of how she passed.
Right. Well, yeah. And I'm not. So there in Alabama, I said, and I told friends, it's like, all right, well, you know what was up. Yeah, it was an overdose. And it was almost necessary because people would look at me like I did it, you know. So
no, this is because of the last argument that you and Nicole had, she said, is why you feel that. But
like I told her on the 25th, I said the children can move in with me. I just got a place. But, I said the children, we was, you know, out on the streets.
Yes.
The children can move in with me. And then we had argued via text and just back and forth. I called her mother and I said, have you talked to your daughter? And she said, no. And I said, why not? So she said, well, she's not answering the phone. So, okay, well, at least you made contact with her. So I'm venting to her mom.
Right.
And then the next day she passed away. She passed away the next day. I thought she passed on the 27th, though, because the DHR called me on the 27th in the morning. But she passed on the 26th at night. And it's like, what happened? What, you just gave up the ghost as soon as I tell you the children can move in with me?
No.
You know?
No, listen. This is what she's saying to you. No. She knew that the children belonged with you. And know that she has given them and will continue to give them what they needed. Yeah. Really have. She was dealing with a lot of darkness inside of herself.
Oh, yeah.
And I know you know that.
Yeah.
But in no way. She does not hold you responsible for any of it. She loves you, and she knows that you will take great care of the children. Yeah.
Do I need to investigate this conspiracy? I mean, is it a conspiracy?
No, it's not.
You know, was it just an overdose?
It was.
Or should I? Huh?
No. This was Nicole's doing by her own hand. Yeah. Yeah. Ashe. Know that she's seen an opportunity for her soul to leave, and she left.
Mm-hmm.
And I know my heart goes out to you and to the children and to the whole family and also to her.
One question, she had a child way out of bed, and I'm just wondering, is it possible to get that? I mean, do you have any, are you showing any energy towards that?
No, I don't. I really don't show any energy towards that. I don't. I would tell you, James, I really don't pick up any energy towards that at all. I really don't. Okay. Well, know that I love you. I'm here to support you. You know how to reach out to me if you need to. And I want you to know that Nicole is definitely with you and the children and the family. You have a total of seven spirit guides that are with you, near you, that is around you to support you at this time. But she said she has nothing but love for you. You are and will always be her greatest love. And she loves you. And there's no one better that she'd feel more honored to be the father of you guys' children. All right.
All right. Thank you.
You're so welcome. Hold the line. Hold the line.
Peace and love.
Peace and love. Oh, wow. Powerful. Very powerful. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this time, and I'm going to keep taking calls here for everyone here tonight. But I do want us to take a moment. And we're going to do a little bit of a spirit quest just for us to kind of go deep down in ourselves at this time, just to kind of clear some energy, bring some energy up, also release some things inside of ourselves, and just to send love out to our whole soul group here, and really to just call our spirit guides in, our loved ones, our ancestors, and really just put a light of harmony and love over everyone all over the planet. So let's get started. The first thing that I want you to do is just to relax. If you're sitting down, I want you to sit with your back nice and straight. Just sit up straight so your spine is straight. Whenever we have our spine straight, it ensures that all of our energy centers are able to just expand themselves outward and able to pull in the information, the energy that we need inside of our mental bodies and our spiritual bodies. Keep your feet planted flat on the ground. And if you're in the position, I want you to close your eyes. And then I want you to take a deep breath, nice and deep, inside through your nose. That's it. That's it. And slowly release it out. That's it. Just letting yourself just kind of go for the moment. And just breathe very gently. Allow yourself to just go within. I want you to allow your senses to come alive. So notice the feeling of the temperature of the room or the space that you're in. Does it feel warm? Can you feel a breeze? Just notice how your skin is feeling. And so now, we're going to take a journey. We're going to be going to Grand Central Station so that you can come face to face with your spirit guide or your ancestor or a loved one who's passed away, just so you can see them for a moment, just so you can meet them face to face and just have a conversation with them. So now, just relax for me. Gently keep breathing. And what I want you to do is to imagine coming down from up above your head this emerald green light. It's almost a neon light. And as this light begins to shine down and it begins to come in through your crown chakra, which is in the center of the top of your head, I want you to feel it electrifying your brain, your head. You might even feel your hair tingling on your neck and allow that light to propel itself throughout your head as it began to swirl itself around, going through your pineal gland, coming around to your third eye, coming down, and now this emerald green electric light is right over your physical eyes. I want you in your mind's eye to see the light propelling itself outward of your physical eyes, shining bright in front of you. And now the light coming out through the back of your head, right there, right through the back of your hair where your third eye is. Right there, through the back of your head. And all the way down, down through your neck, down, down further, all the way down, coming in through your heart, covering you all over, down. Further down through your legs, coming all the way down, going through all of your energy centers, your sacral chakra, your solar plex, down, down through your legs, both your right and your left. This electric green light, and all the way out through your root chakra, which is at the sole of your feet, and down, down into the ground. Your whole being is lit up, electrified, and you can feel the energy as it's moving itself throughout your physical body. And I want you to relax, because this has cleared away any thoughts that was taking you off focus, that was weighing too heavy on your heart and your spirit. And it's lifting you up. And you're raising your vibration higher and higher and higher. Now, I want you in your mind's eye to walk with me. We're getting ready to go into Grand Central Station, and you have raised your frequency and vibration. So whether it's one of your ancestors you want to connect with, or perhaps a loved one, or your spirit guide, they will see you. They will find you amongst the crowd and come right to you. So on the count of three, we're going to walk into Grand Central Station, and I want you to begin to walk around until you find who you're looking for. One, two, three. You've walked inside. So now, look around. You can go anywhere you want. They are looking for you. Some of your spirit guides and loved ones are holding up signs with your name on it because they've been waiting for you. Go, find them, talk with them, sit with them. They have a message for you. That's it. Oh, I see some of you have found your loved ones, your spirit guides, and some of your ancestors. This is beautiful. Find a bench. Find a corner where it's not too loud so you can go and you can ask them a question. Stay with what's on your heart. Let them speak to you now. They've been waiting for you. Yes. Yes. Don't get distracted. Keep looking. You will find them. They are there for you. They have your message. It's the one you've been waiting for. Yes. That's it. Let him speak to you. And share that message that you've been waiting for. Yes. They've been waiting for you and waiting for this moment. That's it. You can talk to more than one of your loved ones. You can speak with your spirit guides and the ancestors. That's it. Ask the question. If nothing is coming up, know that they have a message, a word for you. this is going to help you. It's going to take you into 2018 and beyond. Just be open to receive. They are so excited to see you. They've been waiting for you all day long. They are so glad that you're here. Yes. So now, I want us all, with your spirit guides, with your ancestors and your loved ones, for us to come to the center where the clock is. Come to the center where the clock is. Let's all stand in a circle. Look around. See all of the love and support that you have there for you. Know that your spirit guides and the ancestors are here to support you, to love you, and to help you. Take one final look as we get ready to come back. Thank them. Thank them for their gifts. Cherish this time. Listen to the message they have for you. Feel the energy as this electric light still keeps illuminating your body, charging you up, and giving you the clarity and the energy and the love that you need. All right, it's time for us to start making our way back. On the count of three, I want you to begin to get ready to start walking towards the door. You will see the light shining over the door. That's the door we're going to be going out of. So as I count to seven, when I get to seven, you will come back remembering all that happened and everyone you connected with, feeling energized, charged up, and your heart chakra beautifully open and in harmony. One, two, start walking towards the door with the light. Three, four, five, six, you're almost there. Seven, that's it. You are back. You are back. What an amazing journey. I'm going to give you guys a minute to bring yourselves all the way back. If you have time, I want you to write down what you have. And if you're on the phone lines, when I come to you, I want you to share your experience of who you met, who you seen, what happened, what spirit guide, what ancestor, what loved one was there. And share the message as well. So we're going to continue. Let's go to the phone lines. Calling in from area code 8032. You're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hi, Miss Blue. This is Michelle from Columbia, South Carolina.
Okay, greetings to you, Michelle, from Columbia, yeah. South Carolina. How you enjoying the share tonight?
Yeah. Oh, it's wonderful. Oh. Excellent, excellent.
Oh.
Very powerful tonight.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Did you get a chance to go on this spirit quest?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
You want to share with...
And that was really... Oh, okay. It was really amazing. Something special happened today. I have this project in the house, and I finally decided to tackle it. And I felt like I was getting help from my spirit guides.
Oh, beautiful.
So I want you to find out if they did help me, because I ended up doing something completely different. It was still cleaning up, but it was in the another area of the house rather than the major one I wanted to tackle.
Wow.
So ask them if that was them helping me and if I have a good plan to tackle the bigger problem.
Okay.
Because I felt like I was getting help.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to tell you something. You actually was getting help. And interesting enough, one of your spirit guides that was there is an amazing woman. She actually is from Las Vegas, Nevada. And if you can believe this or not, which is this is so amazing. This is why I love this work. She worked at the MGM Grand Hotel, and she was a maid there. She was a housekeeper there in the hotel. And I know this for sure because one of my spirit guides, she also worked for her as well. So I'm going to show you the connection here, which I think this is really, really cool. So she worked at the MGM Hotel, and she was one of the housekeepers there. She was actually in charge of housekeeping there. And she was a stickler for clean bathrooms, bedrooms and bathrooms and closets. That's her thing. Like, she's a big stickler, very organized, and she was very clean with what she was doing. In fact, she was working the day when one of the largest fires that have ever happened at the MGM Grand Hotel, where 85 people made their transition. This happened back in November 21st of 1980. And what happened,
oh my goodness.
And you're going to see how this is tied into some of the things that you were kind of concerned about that tied in. The cleaning closet was left open with cleaning supplies, and the room next door is where the fire started. And because that door was left open and those chemicals of those cleaning supplies was there, it ignited the fire and it caused the hotel to catch on fire. And in fact, more than most of the people who passed away, they passed away from smoke inhalation. That's what they passed away from. She was able to get out, and she was able to save so many from getting out. And one of the things that you are attempting to do is to clear the clutter in your sacred space and to organize things and pull things out. And one of the things that often crosses your mind is if there's ever, forbid, a fire or something happening, there's so many things that could be ignited. And so she definitely was there helping you to get that together. Now, she did at that time, because this was back in the 1980s, and she also worked with one of my spirit guides, or worked for one of my spirit guides, who was a sister by the name of Sarah Ann Knight Pretty. And who Sarah was, is she was the first African-American woman to own a casino in Las Vegas. And she also owned, at one time, she also owned, what do you call that famous place, the Moulin Rouge. She also owned the Moulin Rouge at one time. And your spirit guide also worked with her to help set a lot of these things up. So she also owned another restaurant. She owned a club called the Playhouse Lounge, where she used to also serve food there. And one of the specialties that she was known for was her barbecue sauce. So your spirit guide also says that you're kind of doing some experimenting, mixing up with some things over there too, in that kind
That's
of
right.
way. Yes, ma'am. See, you see, I'm loving this. Like, I'm trying to contain my excitement for you as we move through this. But they worked on this barbecue sauce for months. But nobody could figure out why everybody kept coming to this lounge, because the lounge was called the Playhouse Lounge. And of course, it had all the ambiances of what we thought about back in the 1980s of Las Vegas, the girls, the women, the gambling, the men, the smoke. But really what kept people coming back there, and everybody would come there, no matter who's who in town, was because of the barbecue sauce that they came up with. And they were putting that barbecue sauce on absolutely everything that was there. So she's there, she says, not only to help you with your sacred space cleaning, but also to help you with all these recipes and things that you're coming up with, because she was a woman with a strong entrepreneurial spirit, and she liked to do things on a very grandiose scale. And that's why she's with you.
Awesome. That is awesome. Totally phenomenal.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So what are some of the things that you're working on? Share that with us.
Oh, goodness. If you could see my desk and table... It's like I bring the mail in and I sit it down. I don't want to deal with it. And I just feel overwhelmed with all the stuff here. And then I used to be an administrative assistant. So you know I'm orderly.
That's right.
You wouldn't know it by looking at this.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I want to tackle it, I just want to do it in a way that I can, you know, clear things up and then maintain it and stuff like that. But a lot of it had to do with my energy. I just didn't feel up to it. There was a lot of indecision, a lot of fear. And today, energetically, I was just at a good place.
I love it. Well, you have... You said what now?
I got some good things accomplished today, and actually there was a little surprise because I cleaned up a certain area over there. I had some unexpected guests, and I was like, oh, I'm so glad I did that. Otherwise, this place would really have looked a mess. So, one part of the room was clean, the other part was, you know, just busy.
Oh.
So that's why I said, I know I had help.
Yes. Well, I love it. It is beautiful confirmation. She worked in housekeeping. She worked at the MGM. At the time, it was called the MGM Grand Hotel. I think now it's called Bally's there. But it suffered from the fire. But she worked in housekeeping. She was, in fact, in charge of housekeeping that was there. So as soon as you came on the line, my spirit guide was like, oh, and they both was jumping up and down. I was like, okay, whoever this next person is, they used to work together. So there is your message from the spirit guides. How powerful is that? I also would love for you to share with us what happened during your spirit quest that we just did.
I think I heard from my husband. He's deceased.
Oh, beautiful. I love it.
I think so.
Yeah. Trust yourself. You did. You did.
He came up and said something, and I said hello. Okay. All right. I tell you, that was very powerful. That was amazing. Really was.
Beautiful. Well, you know what happens after we do this spirit quest? They continue in our dream state. So when you get ready to lay down tonight, you know, set that intention to continue that conversation, because of course your husband is around you. Of course he's there with you, also helping to guide you and to be with you as well. So I know you have some questions for him, and he has some things he want to share with you, and you can get those from him as well. How powerful is that? Wow. I love it.
That's truly good. Yeah.
Well, it is awesome. So good hearing from you. Thank you so much for calling in. Harmony and love to you. Hold the line for me. I'm just loving you guys tonight.
Okay, thank
you. Energy is amazing. And Ashe to your husband as well. He's smiling over there. He said he don't know what this shit is, but it's crazy. He love it. And that's his exact words. He says, I don't know what this is, but I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Okay.
All right. Hold the line. Beautiful. Oh, wow.
Okay.
Let's go to the next caller calling in from area code 9802. 9802, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
My name is Selena, and I'm calling from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Okay, greetings to you, Selena, from Charlotte, North Carolina. Yes, ma'am. Did you get a chance to do the spirit quest?
Oh, yeah, I did. I was having a little trouble, like, keeping my mind, you know, the mind chatter down. Mm-hmm. But I did do the spirit quest.
Okay. Did you get a chance to connect with either your spirit guide or loved one or one of your ancestors?
I didn't really get any messages, but it did seem like a woman appeared, like, with no face, and maybe in, like, a pilgrim type of, I don't know, just a weird person. And then I also, you know, felt like other people were there. I wasn't sure if it was, you know, deceased family members or not, but it was like they were just standing there, and I really didn't get a message.
Okay. But you were,
I don't know if it was not being open to receive. I don't know.
No. You know, if you're not used to doing a spirit quest, because it's quite different than meditation, it sometimes can take a little while for you to kind of settle in. But the fact that you were able to see something really speaks to your clairvoyance. Because you were able to see, you know, so it really shows that you're tapped in. And I'm sure that the more that you do these spirit quests with us here on Planet Remix, the more open and more centered you'd become, you know. And even one of the things I love about the spirit quest is, even though you leave here, you may be tomorrow at work, or you may be asleep or waking up or brushing your teeth in the bathroom or driving, and all of a sudden you'd be like, now I know what that was, you know, like it all sort of kind of unfolds for you and kind of drop in. So trust where you are. I that's beautiful. I will tell you, interesting enough, you have 5 spirit guides that are with you at this time. And of the 5 spirit guides, one of your spirit guides is actually, this is interesting. One of your spirit guides is actually from the ATL, from Atlanta. And she was in Atlanta in the 1960s. And one of the things that she did when she was in Atlanta, she used to work on a farm. And she worked on a farm where a portion of the farm, her family kind of did like a co-op, where they paid for, you know, to use the land to, you know, to grow fruits and to grow vegetables. And then they would go to the farmer's market and they would sell those fruits and vegetables. And interesting enough, tomatoes was her fruit of choice, or her vegetable of choice, tomato. She loved tomatoes, like all types of tomatoes. And she would make this tomato salad that people would die for, like literally. Like, she knew how to pick these tomatoes, chop these tomatoes up. She'd mix in some green onions, her special sauce, and people would love her tomatoes. She made tomato sauces with them, like spaghetti. Like, she did a lot with tomatoes. Interesting, the sister before it was barbecue sauce, and now we're on tomatoes, but she worked on the farm. But one of the things she found is like getting into that form of horticulture and working with the plants and working with the soil brought her so much peace. And it really helped her to stay balanced, because she said in her later years, she started to have lots of hormonal problems. Her hair was falling out, her weight was fluctuating, going up and down, up and down. And at that time, they really didn't have like a lot of medications and treatments, and the things that they had, she wasn't interested in getting or using for herself, because she always had very thick hair. But her hair started to fall out and get very thin, and she noticed that even if she wasn't eating, she was gaining weight, and if she was eating, it was like things were all over the place, and it was her hormones. And by being out in nature and connecting with nature, she was able to bring this into balance for herself. And she really passed this on to other women as well, too. And she did all of this through the tomato plant. So tell us how you relate to this.
Very interesting. Because when I tell you the hormonal issues I'm having, I mean, I'm having all kind of high flashes, weight gain, all of that, what you say.
Wow, I love this. I love it.
it's very, very challenging. I mean, I try to get outside, you know, when I'm at work, I don't plan or anything like that. But
right.
I do try to make a point when I get to, sit out on the bench and sit outside. And, I mean, outside always, calms me and makes me feel a little better. But, yeah, I am having some hormonal issues. I'm really bad right now.
So here's what I want you to do. This is why she stepped up first. She is your spirit guide. You have five of them. And out of your spirit guide, three of them are women and two of them are men. But she's the one stepping forward to really help you bring this into balance. And I want you to work with her. I also want you to start buying some tomatoes. But buy the tomatoes, she says, that are still on the vine. And at least try to eat a couple of slices of those tomatoes a day. And when you do that, I want you to connect with your spirit guide, because she's going to tell you what foods you need to eat and things you need to do to get your hormonal situation under control. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Yeah, I need
powerful.
I love tomatoes anyway.
Do you? Powerful. Mm-hmm. Wow. Right on point. I love it. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I love that.
Is father coming through at all?
Say it again. You kind of broke up a little bit on my end.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is my father coming through at all?
Let's see if we can reach Daddy. What's his name?
Harold. We called him Harold or Harold.
Harold. Let's see. Harold. Okay, so your dad is coming through. Interesting enough, tell me, your dad had some real interesting political thoughts, because he's coming through and he's fussing about Richard Nixon. I'm like, what?
Really?
Yes, he's saying some stuff about Richard Nixon, like calling him Tricky Rick. He has nicknames for them. Yeah, he's watching television. So I know that must have been a big part of what he did, is watch television, because he's watching TV.
Oh, yeah, a lot.
Okay, so this explains it. And he's also saying, boy, oh boy, he sure loved meeting Coretta Scott King. So he's talking about Coretta Scott King, Martin Luther King's wife. So, yeah, he said he's in a good place doing good things. He said he basically just wants his family to keep they shit together. And he's saying it like that. He definitely is sending his love to you and to all the family. He's holding up a birthday cake. It's not, it doesn't have any candles on it. So that tells me that this month or the coming, this is something significant to the family or to him. Because whenever they show, it's like a celebration. What's going on? What's happening with someone in the family on this particular month here in November? What, how is this significant?
November. I don't know about in this month, but you know, we all are Pisces. All our birthdays, like my birthday is the first, and his is the 11th, and my mom's is the 30th.
Yeah, this isn't the birthday because I don't see candles on a cake. And whenever I just see a cake and no candle, then I know it's some sort of celebration, something the family would know. You may need to talk to your mom or something, but something significant about this particular month. Where there is some sort of celebration, a trip happened or something happened during this month that was to celebrate when your father was here. He's showing me this cake and he's also showing me a car. So make note of that, a cake and a car. So,
card.
A car, oh, okay. C-A-R, a car, like you drive a car.
Hmm.
A car. So something about this month is significant. Talk to your mother. She may know. Maybe he purchased a car during this particular month and there's a story behind it. But he's showing me a car, or either you're about to get a car. Somebody's about to get a new car because he's telling me that he's going to be right there because he has the cake and it's a celebration and it's around a car. So it has something to do with a car and he's super excited about it.
Wow. Okay. Cool.
Yeah. So please come back and give that confirmation. Yes.
What were you saying?
No. I said make sure.
Oh, no, I was just.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I will look. I will look. I'll take a new car.
I know that's right. I'll take one too, Daddy. I mean, come on, you giving out cars? yeah. Yes, go ahead.
Is any of the saying anything about, like, I'm thinking about doing like a subscription service business and, you know, just looking for some additional income coming in, and that's one of the ideas I had. Any of helping me out with that?
Well, you definitely do have a spirit guide that has worked in the business world before. So I definitely want you to reach out to him. He's 29 years old and he used to work for a newspaper company. So definitely I'm sure that he can help you with subscription services because we know newspapers is all about subscriptions, or they used to be back in the day. So definitely reach out to your spirit guide. I think it's an amazing idea, as well as the spirit guide that stepped forward, the one to tell you, because the main thing you have to do is definitely balance out these issues you're having, because right now you just don't have the energy to carry out anything. And so once you get those hormonal things under wraps, then it's going to help you move into the next phase of all of these amazing ideas that you've had running around in your head. So beautiful. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sounds good. One more thing, and that's it, I promise. Is a boo on the way, or...
Well, you know, we can always attract love and we can always attract what we are. So I would like to say to know that you are broadcasting that, but you may want to change that conversation from a boo, because a boo, I have you boo-hooing. You understand? You don't want a boo, you know, so get real specific in really what you're ready for. And really start to embody that reflection so you can start to put that out. But there's absolutely no reason, you're a beautiful woman, a sister, that you cannot attract someone to come into your life. But I really feel like right now it is your time to really get centered, grounded, and focused. And please don't go out here looking for anything, because it will not be anything that you imagine or would want. So don't become desperate. Don't do that. Don't send out a desperate plea, because you may not like who answers the call.
Okay.
All right.
All righty, Miss Blue. Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, thanks for calling in. Harmony and love to you. Hold the line. All right. All right, we're going to go to the next caller. Calling in from international number 447. You're live on Planet Remix. Who's on the line, please? International caller, we can't hear you. 44790. Oh, we'll have to come back. Let's see if we can take one more. Let's go to the next caller. Calling in from area code 9026. 9026, you're live on Planet Remix. Please tell us who you are and where you're calling from. Oop, there it is. Well, you guys, listen, it looks like it's so many of you on the phone lines, and I can see you guys there. Oh, my goodness, so many of you on the phone lines. But we only have 8 minutes left to go in the forum. I just want to say thank you to each and every single one of you for joining us here live on Planet Remix and joining us here live in the forum tonight. I'm so glad to have you guys come join us in the forum tonight and with spirit guides. I look forward to hearing everything that you have to say, you know, about your spirit guides and what you guys think about your spirit guides, what happened during the spirit quest. I'd love for you to jump on over to the Remix Radio over on Facebook and share with us who came through, if you were able to speak to someone, what they said, and all of that. Wishing you all an amazing, very hopeful and loving week ahead. loving week ahead as we just kind of coast our way in here into the month of November. Funny how time flies, right? As we get ready to get out of here, I want to send love and light to all of our ancestors out there all over the planet, and love to all of our international listeners listening out there from all over as well. I want to thank you guys for being present, being here with me in this space. I love you all. Don't forget to reach out to me. The workshop is coming. We'd love to have you to be a part of it. And
the truth will set you free.
Just keep knowing your magic. Yeah. Download. Shout outs to Planet Remix.
Wait a minute. top.
Nigga, the Bay run guy.
Wait a minute.
Tell the paparazzi get the lens right.
Wait a minute.
Got the window down top, won't lie.
Wait a minute.
Got the hazard on, only going five.
Wait a minute.
You can catch me.
Bouncing around, bouncing around, bouncing.
Ah, Planet Remix, everyone.
Wait a minute.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Ah, that was Nerd and Rihanna and Lemon. So peace and love to all of you out there. You guys have an amazing week. I would love to hear from you all. Please go over to the Remix Radio page over on Facebook. Click like. Don't forget to subscribe to YouTube. Don't forget to download, download, download. Don't forget to pass the show on and to share what you took away from tonight's share. So until we meet again, you guys, much love to all of you out there. I thank you for bringing your amazing energy, your loving light, and thank you for being a magic maker and a part of Planet Remix. Ashe, ashe, peace and blessings and harmony.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio. Goodbye.